Hi, we made it. Live TV, work without a net. How you doing? Wednesday, 20th day of January, 2021. I'm Dan Kuntz. Welcome to another day here in the Wenatchee Valley. Thanks for starting your day with us here on the NCW Live Channel. 27 degrees, fairly clear skies. Things are going to start changing weather-wise. Nothing dramatic. Could even see a light snowflake. I don't know. We'll find out. But for the most part, the weather will continue to be fairly quiet for the north central Washington area. It's just going to get a little cooler by the time we get to the weekend. Forecast details are coming up. Quite a bit of news to get to on this inauguration day. Sports, we finally have a football schedule. We hope it happens. Everything is still fluid, of course, as you well know. But I think maybe we'll be televising some football games come March. I'm looking forward to that. It's been a long time. We miss doing it. Plus the obscure holiday, today in history, and everything else you need to start your day. And we had a chance to visit with Leslie Freytag, general manager of the Pybus Public Market. We went down and visited Leslie yesterday because the Pybus is open again for indoor dining. You'll have to pack a jacket, but it's well worth the time. We'll catch up with Leslie and the fascinating story of how it came to be. We'll have that for you in the back half of the hour. It's about 3 minutes after the hour. Let's see what we got out there. On this Wednesday morning, the cross camera does the honors. And as you can see, we do have a few more clouds and a little bit of fog that we have not had over the last couple of days. It was another beautiful day yesterday, topped off at 37. The low was 26. Our long period of temperatures either slightly above normal or well above normal continues. It's been a very mild winter. Started out normal in late December, and then it kind of got warm, and it's kind of stayed mild anyway. All things considered, it is January. After all, we're not going to see temperatures in the 60s, but still, we've had a lot of high temperatures in the mid-40s so far in early 2021. 9 hours and 6 minutes of daylight. You can expect today. Sunrise at 7:39, sunset 4:45. Good morning to the valley from our cross camera. Camera number two. Megan wants to pay a little visit to, well, that's got to be Lake Chelan, I'm thinking. So, I don't know. I want to say Lower Butte. That's Bear Mountain. Okay. Well, we haven't used that camera for a while. Yeah, as a matter of fact, that's a good view of Bear Mountain. That's pointed to the northwest. You can see where the lake channels down to that narrow little area before it fattens back up again on the way up to Stehekin from our Bear Mountain camera, not far from the golf course. So that's Manson, I think. You can see pretty much to your right there. And it looks like they're dealing with some clouds and some fog up at Lake Chelan as well. Camera number three. Ooh, Tumwater? Hey, good morning to Leavenworth. That's our Tumwater Canyon camera. It's located about 75, 80 feet right before you go into the Tumwater Canyon. There's a big ridge there, and that's where we positioned that camera. So that is Leavenworth, a Bavarian village, and a beautiful sunrise in the upper left-hand corner of your screen. Man, these cameras are cool. These SkyFi cameras, number four. I'm kind of excited now. Where are we off to? Let's pay a visit to, oh, wow, that's got to be Badger Mountain. It isn't? Is it Badger? Wow, good for me. I almost said Black Mountain, but there's no trees. So good morning to the Wenatchee Valley from high atop Badger Mountain, the Cascades off in the distance. That's the Wenatchee Valley down there. That's a cool view with the clouds and the fog. And, of course, that camera is up above the clouds and the fog. That is sweet. Again, it's hard to believe that that's actually a live shot and not a painting that somebody did. That would be a really good photo for, like, the desktop wallpaper on my computer. It would look cool. Good stuff this morning from my partner 3M from the National Weather Service. Here we go. What do we got? We got this. Partly cloudy skies today. Again, we're dealing with some patchy freezing fog and some clouds, and we'll see some sun breaks. Basically, we're going to repeat what we did yesterday for the most part. And maybe a little bit warmer, 39, they tell us, for the afternoon high. Again, we hit 37 yesterday. Not a big difference between 37 and 39. It's almost imperceptible. Mostly cloudy, overnight low about 31. Weak system's going to come in on Thursday. Snow level's going to be right down here at the valley floor, right about 600, 700 feet. But it's not packing a big punch. I mean, we're talking maybe half an inch of snow possible on Thursday. Maybe a rain-snow mix at times. We'll top off at 37, 28 for the overnight low with fairly cloudy skies on Thursday night. Then a beautiful weekend coming our way. Friday, sunshine and 38. The overnight low Friday night going to be chilly, all the way down to 21. So the cold air is going to come down from Canada. It's going to hang around, as you can see, Saturday. Sunshine and 35 degrees. Sunday, mostly cloudy, about 33 degrees. Could see a couple of light snowflakes. No snow accumulation expected at all on Sunday. And then the cold air will be hanging around Monday and Tuesday. Very typical January weather once we get to Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. But all in all, just not a lot happening out there. Again, maybe a half an inch of light, fluffy snow for the Wenatchee Valley on Thursday morning. We'll see if that pans out. It's just a little short wave that's going to go whoop, kind of flip in and flip out. Passes continue to be no problems at all. It's a live shot of Snoqualmie Pass. You're fine. No advisories, no restrictions. The roadway is bare and dry, and you are down the road. Stevens, it's the same thing. Roadway is bare and dry. There are no advisories. There are no restrictions. No snow. In fact, it's warmer at the summit of Stevens Pass. It's 30 degrees up there. It's 27 down here on the valley floor. And Blewett, bare and dry. Some frost and ice in places. No advisories. No restrictions. So on the big three, Blewett, Snoqualmie, Stevens, no advisories, no restrictions, no snow in the forecast until the weekend. And even then, they are not expecting a great deal of snow up in the mountain passes. So it's going to be quiet up there, just like it's going to be quiet down here from Mother Nature's perspective. Going to take a break. When we come back, we will have your Wednesday morning news. You're watching Wake Up Wenatchee Valley on the NCW Life Channel.
CVCH wants to make your winter just a little brighter with their Get Out and Explore gift giveaway. This December and January, visit cvchgetout.com and download fun, safe, and simple activity guides to four beautiful towns in our backyard. Wenatchee, Chelan, Cashmere, and Leavenworth. Most activities are free of charge and unique to the community you visit. So get out and explore. Visit cvchgetout.com for details.
Mary Maids of Wenatchee has been professionally cleaning and sanitizing homes and businesses in North Central Washington since 1998. Mary Maids uses commercial grade cleaners and viricides. Mary Maids has implemented additional safety and sanitation protocols. They are strictly following CDC guidelines for the safety of their clients and employees. For expert help with cleaning and sanitizing your home or business, call or look up Mary Maids of Wenatchee to schedule your free estimate today.
Just about 10 minutes after the hour, we have a few clouds and some fog in spots. We're at 27 degrees. Once the sun gets up and going, it should be burning off the clouds and the fog. We'll see high temperatures in the upper 30s. Light snow possible on Thursday. Sunshine for Friday and Saturday. And here are your headlines on this inauguration day. A cyber attack took out a lot of systems used by the government of Okanagan County. This happened on Monday, delaying jury trials and limiting other county operations. The sheriff's office said the incursion is affecting email, phone lines, and vital computer systems. IT personnel, information technology folks are working to alleviate the problem. County officials remained open, but county offices, I should say, remain open, but services are limited, and officials are not saying when all the services might be restored. Now, last month, Ellensburg fell victim to a similar attack. This was a ransomware attack that encoded the city's data. Thieves demanding money from the city of Ellensburg before operations were restored. Governor Jay Inslee on Monday announced forward progress in Washington's COVID vaccine program. An additional 400,000 people statewide are now eligible to receive the vaccine, with a target of 45,000 vaccinations per day. Plus, Wenatchee next week will receive its own mass vaccination site.
And the first tier of phase 1B is changing so that all Washingtonians who are 65 and older will be eligible to receive vaccines starting immediately. Now, the reason for this is clear. About 80% of all COVID deaths in the state of Washington have occurred to individuals who are 65 and older. So our vaccine prioritization obviously reflects the need to protect these most vulnerable Washingtonians. Now, in addition to that, Washingtonians age 50 and over who are living in multi-generational households will also be eligible in this tier, one of our measures to reflect our desire for equity in our community. So this is taking place immediately. So people over the age of 65 and those, as I've described, are eligible. are now eligible to go get vaccines, and we hope people will. We are setting up the following sites that will begin vaccine administration starting next week: at the Spokane Arena in Spokane, the Benton County Fairgrounds in Kennewick, the Town Toyota Center in Wenatchee, and the Clark County Fairgrounds in Ridgefield. So the state's allocation for doses for next week will be divided between these sites and pharmacies and local clinics to begin 1B vaccinations, as well as existing vaccination large-scale high-throughput sites that are currently under development in Snohomish, King, and Pierce counties. We want to have statewide coverage in this degree, in this respect.
Now, as far as dates and times for getting vaccinated at the Town Toyota Center, the vaccination, well, they haven't set that yet, but all people 65 years of age and older, and anybody 50 or older who's living with two or more generations in a single household, they will get priority when it comes time to get your vaccine. A Wenatchee man is accused of causing a vehicular crash that injured his 11-year-old passenger. This happened Saturday night. 31-year-old Skyler Stephen Lee faces a possible charge of vehicular assault. Wenatchee police say Lee crashed his own vehicle into a parked car in the 1400 block of Okanagan Street about 7 o'clock. The child suffered a concussion in the wreck, and police said Lee showed signs of impairment. He was scheduled to make his first appearance yesterday in Chelan County Superior Court. The Leavenworth National Fish Hatchery is going to get some money. $6.1 million in federal funds were allocated for water infrastructure. Fourth District Congressman Dan Newhouse announcing the appropriations late last week. Now, alongside the hatchery, reservoir, and groundwater projects in the Columbia Basin will also share the federal money. And another $7.7 million will go to water projects in the Yakima River Basin. The Manson Chamber of Commerce said they raised a lot of money, about $26,000. Was raised for Lake Chelan Swim at the annual Polar Bear Plunge. Lake Chelan Swim offers free swim lessons to local kids. The swim in the icy waters of the lake, part of a week-long Winterfest celebration. We got a video, by the way, from the Chelan Chamber, and you get to see a lot of brave souls who took the plunge into the frigid waters of Lake Chelan.
And here you can see the group that's going to be...
Amazing.
Amazingly cold.
Craziest thing I've ever done, actually.
It was so cold, it hurt.
Good for them. For the money they raised, anyway. Finally this morning, the woman in the Seattle Times, once called Soap Lake's first citizen, passed away. The death of lodging, entertainment, and restaurant legend Marina Romery was announced Monday by her business partner at their resort that they lived in Mexico. For decades, Romery owned and managed Don's Steakhouse, the Soap Lake Businessmen's Club, and The Notaries Inn, a series of rustic cabins, Rosemary, helping draw tens of thousands of visitors to Soap Lake by bringing big-name entertainers to the club. For a few years in the 1980s, she had a mud wrestling pit outside her club. Contestants grappling in Soap Lake's famous muck when she was serving as the mayor of Soap Lake. Rosemary famously wrestled Police Chief Dick Robinson to a draw after selling her Soap Lake business 6 years ago. Rosemary spent her winters in Mexico's California Baja Sur at the Kurt and Marina Resort, which she owned with partner Kurt Graham. Sad day for our friends in Soap Lake, and that's what's making headlines at 17 minutes after the hour. We're already working on a number of news stories for the news tonight at 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and 10 o'clock. Eric Granstrom handling sports. Grant with the weather forecast. He's also the anchor. And with a preview, here's Grant Olson.
Good morning, Dan. Coming up tonight on the NCW Life Evening News, our unseasonably warm weather continues this week, but much cooler temperatures coming by this weekend. I'll have all the details in your North Central Washington weather forecast, and Eric Granstrom will be in with a look at the day's sports. That and all the day's news coming up tonight at 5, 6, and 10 on the NCW Life Evening News. We hope to see you then. Dan?
Thank you, Grant. If you got a news tip, we invite you to go to our Facebook page and drop us a note via Facebook Messenger or go to our website at ncwlife.com. Our email address is on the fritz right now. They're working on it. But our email address has been well laid out for the last couple of days. So if you try to email us at news at ncwlife.com, we're probably not going to get it for a while, but it's coming back. In the meantime, if you want to get a hold of us, do it via our website or via our Facebook page. Going to take a break. When we come back, we have ourselves a football schedule for March. I know it's the new COVID reality that we're dealing with, and we'll talk about that when we come back with sports. You're watching Wake Up Wenatchee Valley on the NCW Life Channel.
It's estimated that one-third of Americans do not have a financial plan. At D.A. Davidson, their advisors are working to change that because they understand the importance of planning for the future. At D.A. Davidson, they believe in partnering together to build a strategy tailored to your needs. They spend the time and have the knowledge to help keep your financial future on track. Let D.A. Davidson Financial Advisors of Wenatchee put the strength of advice to work for you.
Hey folks, Carrie from Blueberry Hills. Looking for great food that's also an experience? Come on out to Blueberry Hills in Manson. Open year-round and named one of the top four restaurants in the state worth the drive for breakfast by the Seattle Times. Serving down-home scratch country cooking with huge portions at family-friendly prices. Great food and a fun experience for the whole family, and definitely worth the drive. For more information, check our website at wildaboutberries.com.
That's a spectacular shot from our cross camera. Sports at 20 minutes after the hour. Athletic directors in our area released a tentative football schedule on a Tuesday. They're taking a cue from the WIAA's restart plan. Of course, also following the governor's Healthy Washington initiative. There's eight regions in the state. So the decision was made that here in North Central Washington, they're going to do away with classifications and just go by geography. So we got 25 schools in the North Central Washington region. So after practicing for a couple of weeks, there are going to be three jamborees will be on Saturday, February 27th. Brewster, Tenasket, Oroville, Chelan, and Omak will be at the Apple Bowl in Wenatchee with groups of games starting at 3 and 6:30. Lake Roosevelt, Manson, Waluk, Eastmont, and Cashmere would gather in Quincy, and then Moses Lake would be hosting Okanagan, Ephrata, Warden, Cascade, and Royal, again, all on Saturday, February 27th. And then varsity football will kick off on Friday, March 5th, all games kicking off at 7 o'clock. The schedule has Moses Lake at Wenatchee, Eastmont at Royal, Waluk hosting Ephrata, Cashmere at Quincy, Chelan taking on Cascade, Omak at Okanagan, Brewster traveling to Manson, Lake Roosevelt at Tenasket, and Oroville and Warden would play at a neutral site. And that means we get to finally televise high school football. I hope we remember how. We're good. We'll do it. Our tentative schedule consumes 5 weeks. It starts on March 5th, runs through April 2nd, opening night would be Moses Lake at Wenatchee. The following week would be the first of two meetings between Wenatchee and Eastmont. March 12th will be at Wildcat Stadium. Then we'll bring you the Pear Bowl for the first time ever. Cascade at Cashmere. That'll be followed by Ephrata at Eastmont on March 26th. And then finally Eastmont at Wenatchee on April 2nd. The rest of the season of the fall sports schedule anyway, is expected to be out Friday. And when it's out, we'll try and figure out what we're going to do as far as televising girls soccer, volleyball, maybe even a swim meet or two. We'll find out, hopefully, by Friday afternoon. Men's college basketball hits the hardwoods tonight, and here's your schedule. Washington will host Colorado in a Pac-12 matchup, 6 o'clock. The game's been picked up, by the way. It'll be televised on ESPN2. Washington State hosts Utah tomorrow at 7. That'll be on the Pac-12 network. Saturday, you got Colorado and Washington State. Also has been added to ESPN2's offering. That's at 5 o'clock. And the Gonzaga Pacific game in Spokane can be seen on Root Sports at 7 o'clock. Women's schedule, they don't get going again until Friday, so we'll wait until Friday. So as far as our broadcast schedule for this week, well, here's what we got for you. We got the Wenatchee Wild against Merritt Centennials from November 1st of 2019. Our checker with the call at 7 o'clock. We'll be Matt's side on Friday night, Big Nine wrestling action between Wenatchee and Moses Lake from last January 16th. Eric has the call of the Panthers and the Chiefs. We'll have that for you at 7 o'clock Friday night. Saturday, Big Nine basketball doubleheader at 2 and 7. Eastmont hosts Sunnyside from January 17th of last year. Grant Olson courtside with the play-by-play. On Sunday, doubleheader of action at the Town Toyota Center. We at first at 2 o'clock from November 2nd of 2019, the Wild and the Merritt Centennials. And then at 7 o'clock on Sunday, that's the rivalry between Wenatchee and Penticton from November 18th of 2019. Take a look at the Les Schwab scoreboard in the NHL yesterday. A lot of games were close, exciting. Yeah, Devils topping the Rangers 4-3. Brian Elliott made 40 saves for the Flyers. They knocked off the Buffalo Sabres in Philadelphia. Frank Vatrano scored 250 in overtime. Florida beat Chicago. The legend Sidney Crosby scored the game winner a minute 11 in overtime. Pittsburgh knocks off Washington. Winnipeg wins over Ottawa. Good for them in overtime. Detroit and Columbus also went into overtime before the Red Wings won it 3-2. And in the late game last night, Colorado skates past the Kings. Five games on the slate today. There is your schedule. Check local listings for television. And finally, the Mariners preparing for spring training in just a few weeks. By the way, opening day, 71 days away. And the organization announced a way for fans to get closer. They're going to have a virtual baseball bash, 60 events, with access to an assortment of 60 Mariner players, coaches, scouts, front office personnel, broadcasters, you name it, they'll be there. It'll include manager Scott Service, general manager Jerry DePoto, players like Kyle Lewis, J.P. Crawford, Evan White. Of course, there's a lot of buzz about the Mariners. They got good young talent. General manager Jerry DePoto says the plan is to continue to bring along the youngsters and see how the season pans out. But he says the Mariners are going to be competing this year, competing in the American League West.
I feel like the next steps for this team are to continue to integrate the young players to this roster. We feel like there are another handful who are not far off. We'll see once we get down to Peoria and as we progress into the season. But a handful of our more polished or advanced prospects that will have an opportunity in 21. First and foremost, it's to gain that experience, to continue to grow the base with the guys that I mentioned earlier, you know, Chef and Kyle and Evan and the like, and then introduce the next group with the idea that if things break well for us and we get into midsummer and we stay close to this thing and we do have an opportunity to sneak up on the back of the playoff field, that's a possibility for us and would be a goal. You know, it's young teams tend to gel quicker than you might think. We can't go in expecting that we're going to run to the top of the American League West, but I think we can set the goal of competing for a playoff spot, and we'll see how it goes. And if we take a step toward that in 2021, I think that would be a great achievement for our organization.
For you Mariner fans, if you want to participate in the baseball bash, you can just go to the Mariners website, mariners.com. You can go to the Mariner Facebook page, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram. This internet thing. I think I'm gonna get me an internet hookup and find out what this thing is all about. Those are just some of the games that people are playing at 26 minutes after the hour. Four obscure holidays to choose from. Today is National Butter Crunch Day. Today is National Disc Jockey Day. I used to be one of those. They don't call them disc jockeys anymore. They call them radio personalities. Today is National Cheese Lovers Day. Nah, we love our friends, the penguin. National Penguin Awareness Day. You know, our flightless little friends from the Southern Hemisphere, in the cute, they got some problems down there. Their habitat is shrinking faster and faster. That ain't good. We love penguins. Look at that. Look at the little penguin cutie. Fun facts about penguins. There are 17 species of penguins, and they all live in the southern hemisphere. You won't find any penguins up here. Emperor penguins are the big ones. They stand about 4 feet tall. The smallest ones are the blue penguins. They're only about 16 inches tall. A penguin's color is a matter of camouflage. From above, its back is black, of course, so it blends into the murky depths of the ocean. And from below, it's got a white belly, so the predators from the ocean can't see it. And unlike most birds who lose and replace a few feathers at a time, penguins molt all at once. All their feathers just whoosh, fall right off. And so they hang around on land for 2 or 3 weeks while they undergo their new molt. Many penguins will mate with the same member of the opposite sex for their lifetime. They don't practice polygamy there in the world of penguins. In many penguin species, it's the male penguin who incubates the eggs. The females leave to hunt for weeks at a time. And so that's why the males get all pudgy and fat, because they have to survive weeks after weeks without actually eating. The fat gets them through that. Penguin parents, both of them, mom and dad, care for their young until their young are old enough to hunt for food on their own. And because penguins, the number one predators for penguins, natural predators, live in the water, they have no natural enemies on land, and so they're not afraid of humans. They will walk right up to a human being, not knowing that we could do them harm, but we don't, because we love penguins. Today in history, of course, it's Inauguration Day. There's a lot of inaugurations to talk about today. 83 years ago today, January 20th, 1937, Franklin Delano Roosevelt sworn in for his second term as president. This is the first time the presidential inauguration ceremonies took place on January 20th. The 20th Amendment changed the date. It used to begin on March 4th. Now it begins on March 20th. This is the first, January 20th. This is the first one that happened. Also the first time the vice president took the oath of office during the ceremonies on the inaugural platform. Before that, the vice president's swearing in took place in the Senate in a separate ceremony. January 20th, 1941, 79 years ago today, FDR sworn in again for his third term as president. The outgoing vice president, John Nance Gardner, administered the vice presidential oath to his replacement, Henry A. Wallace. They don't do that anymore either. January 20th, 1945, 75 years ago today, FDR is sworn in for his fourth term as president. Of course, we were deep into World War II, so the inauguration was held on the south portico of the White House. It was not held at the Capitol. There was no parade. There were no festivities. They just got it over with. The president spoke for about 3 minutes, and then everybody went home. This was also the last time that the outgoing vice president swore in his successor, which had previously been the practice, and it would not happen again after that. 71 years ago today, January 20th, 1949, Harry Truman sworn in as president after winning a full four-year term the previous November. This was the first televised U.S. presidential inauguration. Truman also restarted the tradition of the inaugural ball. Inaugural balls stopped happening with the inauguration of William Howard Taft in 1909. Truman brought that back. The day before the inaugural ceremony, Truman signed into law a bill that raised his pay to $100,000 a year. Good for Harry. Smart move. January 20th, 1953, 67 years ago today, Ike, Dwight D. Eisenhower, is inaugurated as the 34th president of the United States. He was the first president to actually begin his presidency on January 20th. January 20th, 1961, 59 years ago today, ask not what your country can do for you. JFK, inaugurated as the 35th president of the United States, becoming the second youngest man ever to take the oath of office, and of course the first Catholic. Joseph R. Biden Jr. will become the second Catholic to take the oath of office at 9 o'clock our time this morning. Five first ladies attended the inauguration, believe it or not. That's pretty good. January 20th, 1977, there's Jimmy Carter being inaugurated as the 39th president of the United States of America. This was the last inauguration held on the east portico of the Capitol building. They moved it to the west portico. By the way, exactly 40 years later, Carter, of course, went to the inauguration of Donald Trump, becoming the first president to mark the 40th anniversary of his inauguration. He will not be in Washington, D.C. He's 96 years old. Probably not a good idea to travel during these times. January 20th, 1981, 39 years ago today, Ronald Reagan inaugurated as the 40th president of the United States. 20 minutes later, the 52 hostages being held in Iran were released. This was the first time that the inauguration was held on the west front of the Capitol of the United States. January 20th, 2009, 11 years ago today, Barack Obama inaugurated as the 44th president of the United States, becoming the first African-American to assume the highest office in the land. And we do have a couple of Super Bowls to talk about on Today in History. January 20th, 1980, 41 years ago today, Super Bowl XIV, Pittsburgh defeats the Rams 31-19. Super Bowl 14 became the first team to win four Super Bowls, 103,985 at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, which is still a Super Bowl record. The flagship radio station for the Rams, KMPC, got a great deal. They got an agreement with the Iranian militants and the Ministry of National Guidance in Iran, and the tape recording of the radio broadcast was played for the hostages that were being held in Iran. And the halftime entertainment for Super Bowl XIV, Up With People. Bring them back. And finally, January 20th, 1985, 36 years ago today, the San Francisco 49ers defeated the Miami Dolphins 38-16 to win Super Bowl XIX, sometimes called Super Bowl 19, at Stanford Stadium in Stanford, California. Ronald Reagan, who was inaugurated for his second term that very day, tossed the coin via satellite link from the White House in Washington, D.C. And finally, birthdays. He was born 101 years ago today, always will be known as Dr. Leonard Bones McCoy on Star Trek, both the television show and the subsequent motion pictures. DeForest Kelly, born in the state in 1920, died at the age of 79 in 1999. He was the first Star Trek star to make a lot of money making appearances at Star Trek conventions. He didn't get a lot of residuals from the reruns of Star Trek. The others did, Leonard Nimoy and William Shatner, they cashed in, but DeForest Kelly realized there's a lot of money to be made to go out and pretend you're Bones McCoy for all the Star Trek nerds out there. Made a lot of money doing it too. He's dead, Jim. We miss DeForest Kelly. Buzz Aldrin, the second man on the moon, he stepped foot on the lunar surface about 18 minutes after Neil Armstrong became the first. Buzz Aldrin, 91 years old today. His adjustment after he left NASA was not very easy. He went through depression and alcoholism. He wrote a book that was just a really, really good book. He has since gotten his life back together again, and life is pretty good for Buzz Aldrin. He's 91 years old today. And happy birthday to Rainn Wilson. He's 55 years old today. He'll always be known, of course, as Dwight Schrute on TV's The Office, but he has other projects as well. Happy 55th to Rainn Wilson. Going to take a break. We have a brand new opinion. You've never seen it from Mike Mad Dog Mignotti. He did it remotely from home because that's what we're doing nowadays. And then yesterday I had a chance to go down to the Pybus Public Market and visit with our good friend Leslie Freytag. They're open for indoor dining. That's coming up. You're watching Wake Up Wenatchee Valley on the NCW Life Channel.
Take on the new year in a new Ford from Pat Armstrong Ford. From premium grade muscle to unparalleled performance, take on any payload. The all-new 2021 Ford F-150 at Pat Armstrong Ford. Take on any adventure. Take on every thrill. The all-new 2021 Bronco Sport and 2021 Mustang Mach-E. Built to take on every resolution at Pat Armstrong Ford. We are community strong in East Wenatchee.
Family roles change with time. You may find yourself being an unpaid caregiver to a loved one. Caregiving can be rewarding, but also stressful. Taking care of yourself is vital. Aging and Adult Care of Central Washington has low or no cost services for unpaid caregivers, such as in-home support, care supplies, and counseling. Connect in your local area by calling Aging and Adult Care at 800-572-4459 and mention you're interested in caregiver support.
At Collins Fashions, we are welcoming a new year, 2021. This has been a trying and difficult year for us all. We strive to provide a safe environment for all customers and a fun place to be and to shop. We truly appreciate your faithfulness and efforts to shop local and keep our downtown a viable, strong community. Our thoughts and prayers are with each family and the sacrifices you have made this past year. We pray that we will all have a blessed and healthy new year. Come see us at Collins, where fun meets fashion in downtown Wenatchee.
When you think of Doghouse Motorsports, you might think of motorcycles, but there's a lot more in this house. How about Honda power equipment, from snowblowers to lawnmowers to generators and even water pumps? Honda is the brand that sets the standards. Perhaps you need an ATV or UTV. The Doghouse has the largest selection anywhere. Did we mention watercraft and snowmobiles? And of course, we have motorcycles too. Back it up with terrific customer service and you have Wenatchee's best motorsports store 5 years running. Isn't it time for you to be in the Doghouse?
Arctic Refrigeration and Heating has been serving North Central Washington for 34 years. Arctic provides the finest heating and cooling air quality products for residential and commercial customers, along with prompt and professional customer service. Arctic also offers specialty services like custom sheet metal fabrication of ductwork, coil cleaning, as well as planned fall and spring maintenance for the overall well-being of your system. Arctic is available for emergency calls 24/7. Call Arctic Refrigeration and Heating for your heating and cooling needs.
Winter is a great time to trade in your current hot tub. Turn your old hot tub into money with Blue Lagoon Pool and Spa's trade-in program. You can save $500 to $1,000 off of any new Artesian spa or take advantage of a free Bluetooth music experience. Blue Lagoon Pool and Spa recommends draining your hot tub every 3 months. Ask us about our drain and refill special. Stop on by Blue Lagoon Pool and Spa today.
Hey, this is Mike Mad Dog McNaughty, and everybody is entitled to my opinion. Well, yeah, 2020 sucked. But there's an old prayer that's origination might be from the Jewish tradition, which says this: Lord, let me live in interesting times. Well, these indeed are interesting times, no doubt about it. And there's another saying I like that goes along with this prayer, I feel. It's not what happens to us that defines us, but how we respond to what happened to us that defines who we are. You know, we Americans are spoiled, self-indulgent, and pampered, but we have proven time and time again that in our history that we are resilient, we're adaptive, and we're resourceful. It's true. That's part of our national heritage, part of our national character that gives me hope. This is Mike Mad Dog McNaughty, and that's my opinion.
You don't want to see this happen. It's the oil light on your car. Oil is the lube of life for your car's engine. At Alignment Pros and Express Lube, they pour the best oil your car deserves. Expect fast, friendly, superior service in a clean environment. They'll change your oil and perform a 21-point inspection while you enjoy the comfort of their amazing waiting room. Keep your car in top shape at Alignment Pros and Express Lube in East Wenatchee.
Are you ready to freshen up your home? Boswell's expansive two-story showroom is filled with high-quality furniture that's always discounted to give you their best price every day. Boswell's is receiving new furniture deliveries each week, so you'll be sure to find just what you need for your home without the wait. Complimentary design assistance and free local delivery. Superior customer service and the best value for your money. Start at Boswell's on Easy Street. It's closer than you think.
Wenatchee Power Sports not only has a new owner, but an all-new attitude to match. Speaking of attitude, check out the 2021 models arriving now. Polaris snowmobiles, ATVs and side-by-sides. Yamaha motorcycles, watercraft, ATVs and side-by-sides. KTM motorcycles and the latest edition Beta high-performance motorcycles. Coming this fall, a huge demo event featuring the latest and hottest off-road machines. It's all at the retuned Wenatchee Power Sports, where maximum performance is a way of life. 3031 GS Center Road in North Wenatchee, open Tuesday through Saturday.
Contractors, furniture makers, and weekend do-it-yourselfers around North Central Washington will tell you that Lombard's Hardwood Supply is the place to get what you need. Lombard's full millwork shop can handle jobs large or small. Lombard's has a full line of interior and exterior doors available, as well as custom barn doors. From alderwood to zebra wood and everything in between, it's Lombard's Hardwood Supply on School Street in Sunny Slope. Like us on Facebook and check out our monthly special.
Welcome back to Wake Up in Wenatchee Valley. It's a red letter day for us. We get to see our good friend Leslie Freytag again, and we get to have good news from Leslie and the crew at the Pybus Public Market. We got the press release on Friday. It said come down Monday. We're happening. We're going again. First of all, you look great.
Well, thank you.
And second of all, talk about last week or the whole process about
how did we get here?
How did you get
first
here,
of all, Dan, welcome back to Pybus Market.
Good.
We're delighted to have you back. At all, we learned about this early last week. I actually heard from Dawn Meekum at Visconti's, and she said, you know, I've been talking to the Liquor Control Board, and I think we can open if we can get our CO2 levels down. So we had the same guy came down to visit with us last week. We fooled around with a lot of tests, and our target is if we keep our CO2 levels down below 450 parts per million, we are an open air market. It has a lot to do with what windows we open and all of that. So today we have our east upper windows are open and you can feel the nice breeze. We have our fans kicked up a few notches, so that's working. And then we manage it all day long. We take a reading on our CO2 readers every hour. And if it's starting to creep up, we are managing right about 400 to 405. So it gives us a little leeway. And then if we need to, we just open another door, get it down and see where we are.
You probably never thought in a million years when you took this job from Steve Robinson that you'd be talking about CO2 levels.
Never. And parts per million? How? And where do I get a CO2 reader?
So it was the Liquor and Cannabis Control Board?
Yes, absolutely.
Does the Department of Health play any role in this at all?
If you go to the governor's website that addresses the section that addresses all the COVID areas, you can read all about it. And they've delegated this restaurant opening air kind of thing to the Liquor Control Board.
The first thing I noticed when we got the press release, it was really cute. Bring a jacket.
Yeah.
It is cool.
It's
cool, but it's not cold in here.
No.
That was the first thing I thought of when we walked in here was it's actually almost mild.
It's mild today. Yesterday, I have to tell you, last night we had a big crowd. I shouldn't say crowd. We filled up the tables. We're socially distanced, by the way. 5 per table, 25% capacity. But we had more people here last night, so we had more open, and it was cold. I had dinner with some friends, and we were huddled up a bit.
Well, that's okay.
That's okay. Wine warms you up.
So so you got the word out to your vendors, we can do this, and pretty much everybody's on board.
Yes. We tested it, like I said, we tested it last week. We tried all kinds of different ways, how many doors. We just played around with it last week to see what would work. We talked to everybody here, all of our year-round tenants, and you know, can you live in this? Is this good for everybody? It has to be good for the restaurants, but as well as our shopkeepers too.
I have never, and I've been to Pybus, I don't even know how many times I've been here, I've never seen the windows, the upper windows where they meet the ceiling. I don't recall I've ever even seen them open, or maybe I just wasn't paying attention.
Yeah, we open them periodically, especially when we opened after the shutdown in March, when we reopened in early May, we were able to do that working with the health department, and we opened all the windows and we had all the garage doors open, and that helped us be an open air market so we could reopen a little bit earlier.
Now, South hasn't reopened, but the other restaurants, for the most part, are good to go.
So,
Who's the policing of the social distancing, the parameters that you talked about? Is that up to the individual restaurant?
Yes. So the restaurants are managing the social distancing and the numbers at a table. That's up to them to manage. Today, we are managing all the CO2 levels, and I was just working with our operations guy. Now that we know we can do this, we're looking at ways that we can automate it using our HVAC, and looking at doing something that will open the dampers and close them and put a CO2 reader actually at all of our thermostats. So rather than the running around we're doing today.
We're taping this on a Tuesday. We're gonna air this on a Wednesday. Monday was your first day. It was a beautiful day.
Beautiful.
And you said you had a lot of folks
here. We had a lot of folks all day long who were delighted to be out and about and to see a friend and to meet them for coffee at Cafe Columbia or have pizza for dinner last night. Overall, the feedback has been terrific. People are excited. And most importantly, for everyone that works here, because that's who I was worried about, are all feeling excited about it. And we just put on an extra jacket when we need to.
And it's, again, I have just a sweatshirt on. I'm plenty comfortable.
Yeah,
pointed out that I think I'm indicative of everybody who comes here to the Pybus. You don't come to the Pybus, go to one restaurant or one retail location, buy something and leave.
Right.
You're going to linger around.
You linger.
You're gonna go to the cheesemongers and get a little cheese. You might go grab a cup of coffee at Cafe Columbia or a sandwich.
Yes.
Maybe a little wine from Jones. So you're gonna be hanging around here a little bit. So everybody's in this together as far as your tenants are concerned.
Yes, absolutely. Because we know that if we're able to have more people come and spend some time, that they will shop with them. And so we've seen that. I also want to say that our community was amazing at Christmas. They heard the mantra, shop local, loud and clear, and some of our shops had amazing, amazing December. So thank you to everyone in our community for that.
Are some of the shops and the restaurants that are around here, you mentioned Visconti has kind of planted that seed,
yes.
Are they going to come down here and say, okay, so this is what you're doing, and this is your CO2 levels and your parts per million, we can do this too? Do you feel like maybe you're an experiment in that kind of respect?
It really depends on the facility that a restaurant has and if they have the ability to open enough to get fresh air coming in. So I think it's really going to be dependent on the location where they are.
Well, I'm excited.
We are.
I miss this place. I missed it so much. In fact, it's kind of a funny story. It was maybe mid to late summer. We came down and did an entire interview with you.
Yes.
And the next day, something happened and we couldn't air it.
That's right. I've forgotten now, but something closed and we thought we were moving forward. And that's been the year. Last year was shutting down, moving forward, coming back. And, you know, but we've been, you know, working with everyone here. They've just all been great. Everybody has thought very creatively on how to do business in new ways. And we've all learned a ton through this whole process.
I don't want to put you on the spot, but
yes.
Off the top of your head, I don't have the press release with me, I apologize for
yes.
that. The restaurants and shops that are open now
yes.
and those that are planned. I know South plans on opening at the end of this month.
So at this point, South wanted to close to just take a break.
Good.
And we're looking to have them back when they're ready. We hope it's in February.
I miss their food.
Yes, I miss it too. Fire, as you know, is open for lunch and dinner. They're open till 8:30 every night. Cafe Columbia is open for breakfast and lunch. And the Bistro is still doing their wonderful family takeout meals, and they're figuring out what they're going to do next. So stay tuned for further updates.
But we got a little momentum going here.
We do. And even our tasting rooms last night, they've been busy outside because we have fire pits and we've extended we made some little patio areas. That's gone well. And then to see some folks in here last night enjoying a glass of wine was wonderful.
I love Pybus. I love visiting with my friend Leslie. One more quick shout out before we cut you loose. I know you're busy. The foundation is the foundation. There's a reason they call it that.
Yes.
You
yes.
can't build anything without a good solid foundation. And
yes.
And the folks who you report to.
Yes, our board.
Have been fantastic.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah.
We have wonderful members that are part of our community board that governs Pybus Public Market and the foundation as well. And we just came through a Give NCW campaign where everyone was quite generous, so we're grateful.
One last question, Leslie, I'll cut you loose. A little preview coming up, spring, summer, anything
yeah,
in the hopper
so
you can
we're
talk
busy.
About?
We have a new marketing and events manager, Katie Atkinson, and we're busy working on what we can do. We're going to go back to doing some open-air markets, and we have one scheduled for Saturday, February 13th, the day before Valentine's. So that should be fun, and that will be outside on our plaza. We also are working with the Wenatchee Valley Farmers Market, so if there's any of the farmers that are able to come earlier than the normal May start, we're working to do something there, so stay tuned for that.
And it sure felt good to drive down to the bottom of Arondo Street and see cars and
yes.
see people
yes.
enjoying the Pybus.
Just
again.
Enjoying, yes,
yeah.
yes, it's
got,
great.
Got the warm fuzzies going
oh,
here.
I'm glad,
yeah,
I'm glad.
And it's not the drugs I'm on. You watch Wake Up Wenatchee Valley. Thanks again, Leslie. We won't be strangers.
No.
We won't
Welcome
be strangers.
Back.
Yes, it's good to see you. We'll be right back.
We're here because of the children, because the children need to be protected. Their needs aren't being met.
They didn't ask for any of this stuff. It's not their choices that got them here.
The more adults that a child has that love them, the better off they are.
Children need a whole community to raise them. And if we can do any little thing, it makes a big difference in the child's life.
You love to help others. You need a solid career. You can have it all with help from Charter College. Our 10-month medical assistant program prepares you to work in healthcare settings like physician offices, rehab centers, and clinics. You'll learn to take patient vitals, assist with exams, administer injections, and maintain medical records. When you're ready to launch a rewarding healthcare career, visit chartercollege.edu because we work to get you to work.
Homeward bound, I wish I was homeward bound.
silently for me. Silently for me.
Bring the whole family up to Stormy Mountain Brewing and Local Public House in historic downtown Chelan. Applewood smoked brisket, street-style tacos, and our award-winning barbecue rubs and sauces. Our meals pair perfectly with our exciting lineup of craft ales, made right here in Chelan. We've got room for big groups, or give us a call for catering. So grab the kids and check out the fun at Stormy Mountain Brewing and Local Public House, located in the heart of Chelan.
Back at it, holding steady right around 27 degrees, a mixture of some clouds and a little bit of fog. But all in all, we're in for another beautiful day here in north central Washington. We have a few extra minutes, so we thought we'd take another quick little tour. Now that the sun is up, sun came up at 7:39 this morning, and it won't go down till 4:45. And so we get 9 hours and 6 minutes of daylight today. And it looks like Megan zoomed at the cross camera about as far back as it goes. She says no now. She did not touch the cross cam. Thanks. Nicely done, Dan. Foot and mouth disease strikes again. But that is the Wenatchee Valley because I was born and raised here and I know what it looks like. Megan says it's not the Wenatchee Valley. I'm sorry, it's Dover, Delaware, I'm now being told. Are you okay, Megan? I don't know. Maybe there's a lack of oxygen in the control room. Let's find out where camera number two takes us to. I think that's back to the Bear Mountain camera. That's the Bear Mountain camera looking the other direction. We had it pointed up the lake earlier this morning. Now we have it pointed down the lake at Wapato Point. Obviously some snow in the upper elevations of our Bear Mountain camera. That's not exactly at the golf course. This is one of the high ridges above the golf course, but it's fairly close enough to it that we call it the Bear Mountain camera because we have to give these cameras names, and we almost always use the geographical location or the rough geographical location of where these cameras are. Originally, we gave the cameras names, like Bob and Jerry and Fred and Al and Harry, but that didn't work out because it got all confusing. Camera number three. Well, that was the camera formerly known as Bob, and then we changed it to the Tumwater camera. So good morning to downtown Leavenworth. I believe that's the Wenatchee River off in the background. So our Tumwater camera zoomed in. Obviously, still snow on the ground in Leavenworth. Leavenworth gets more snow. They get it earlier, they get it later, and it sticks around longer because of the shadows. Of course, it's tucked into a very narrow little valley. The temperatures are always cooler there, and it's always more susceptible to more snow than, say, the Wenatchee Valley, where we get a little more sunshine than Leavenworth does. Camera four, if I remember last time we were up at Badger Mountain. Are we back at Badger? We are. That is really cool. She moved the camera again, on the lower right-hand part of your screen, look at that. Oh, isn't that neat? I just want to look at that. You can, the waving wheat obviously is not waving right now. It's not doing much of anything. Just sitting there, covered underneath the snow. But look at that cloud fog bank roll through the very top of Badger Mountain. That's a communications tower to your right. A lot of communication towers up there. Cell phone towers, translators, repeaters, lions and tigers and bears. Oh my, beautiful view from Badger Mountain, looking almost directly to the south of the Wenatchee Valley, which is why you can't really see the valley. Spectacular stuff from my friend Megan. Gonna take a break and come back with your weather forecast. You're watching Wake Up Wenatchee Valley on the NCW Life Channel.
I'm Jenny Rojanasatian, and this is Guada TV. Every week, we will be bringing you a first look at North Central Washington business, tech, and education news. You'll hear from local influencers and innovators who live right here in the Valley. Together, we'll discuss hot topics, current events, and resources that can support your business, our schools, and this community. Join me every week, and let's get inspired.
Oh, that's awesome. Look at that. Yeah.
There he is. Sure wish she's here.
Yeah, no kidding.
Little 4-point.
It's a nice coconut.
Solid fish.
Watch the Northwest Outdoorsman with Richie Harrod Saturdays and Sundays at 6 a.m., 9:30 a.m., and 4:30 p.m. on the NCW Life Channel.
right, our last order of business, your forecast, looks something like this. We're going to repeat pretty much what we had yesterday. Morning clouds and fog burns off to some sunshine later on today. 39, give or take a couple. For the afternoon high, we get 37 on Tuesday, 31 for the overnight low. There's a slight chance of a little bit of light snow on Thursday. It'll happen on Thursday morning if it happens at all. Snow level is going to be right at the valley floor, but and there's a 40% chance of some precipitation of any kind. Whatever happens is not going to last very long. Clouds will be persisting, 28 for the overnight low on Thursday night. Gobs of sunshine Friday, Saturday. A gradual cooling trend, as you see. We go from 38 to 35 to 33. They're going to hover right around the mid-30s on Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday with another chance of some light snow on Sunday. And finally, your mountain passes looking good. No advisories, no restrictions. I-90 is bare and dry. Stevens Pass, US 2, bare and dry. No advisories, no restrictions. Blewett, bare and dry. No advisories, no restrictions. I like it when I can say that. And very little snow is expected into the major mountain passes at all. Just a little bit here, a little bit there. Not enough really to affect the roadways until they get to the weekend. That's it for us. Have a good inauguration day. We'll see you tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.